Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Free VST Plugins Part 2. At this moment, we're going to cover also a few of the instruments that I use in my workflow. I am Ander Verheven, I am audio engineer, producer and educator, and we're going to dive right into the Free VST plugins. Over here, I have one of the most used plugins that every producer has in his library. This is Spawn from Foxengo. I use it on my mixes, I use it on my mastering, I use it on my production, I use it everywhere. This thing, yeah, I can explain a lot of it, but I have to make a new video about it. But for now, I'm gonna show you what this frequency analyzer can do. As you can see, there are some issues in this mix, and as I have known, you can listen to some of the parts in your mix just to hear what is everything doing. But later on, for the extended version and explanation of this wonderful plugin, we move on to the next one. Over here, I have LoudMax. LoudMax is a really great plugin. They are still evolving in new versions. This one is a brick wall limiter and it sounds awesome on your mixing bus or if you have to make a quick tryout of your mix. I use it in combination with Frontier from D6ing Group. So first I used Frontier to cut off all the peaks and it's really great. As you can hear over here in the mix. They're working well together. You can really go loud with this mix, but later on, I can do an explanation video on request. If you guys go down below and ask how do you use this or can you explain more about this. I also have a course of production. If you guys want to follow a course, just hit me up in an email and yeah, let's go for it. I have Zoom, I have Skype. So moving on to the next one. I have TinyQ. It's really nice. Use it for cutting off the low ends and maybe boost a little bit in the highs, but it's really great. It's light CPU. As you can hear, I use it on the main bus over here of the drums. Doesn't make any difference. Only take away from the rumble in the low end. And it's nice. Yeah, you should check it out. I have the link down here in the description. Over here, I have some of the Melda production plugins that I certainly use in my production workflow. As you can see, there's a spectral pen. This one also Logic has a similar plugin of this one. Makes a wider stereo field in frequencies. Over here, we have an analyzer, which is really nice. Okay, I use Spawn, but this one is also nice to check out. I use the M compressor, I use the Wave Shaper and the M convolution. But also the Auto-Tuner and the rest of their plugins are really great to check out. You can download this one and if you like certain parts of the plugins, you can buy them. Or if you like the whole package, buy the whole package. No problem. It's really great. It's a really good additional to your workflow. So moving on to the next one. This is the Tall Reverb. This is my secret weapon to spread out a little bit of the synthesizer. I use it in a special way. It's not mentioned in the signal flow tutorial that I made. The Tall Reverb is really great. You can make your sound bigger. You should check it out. It's really nice. We also have Head Crusher over here. Head Crusher is the free version of the Decapitator of Soundtoys. Yeah, it's similar explanation of their title, Head Crusher. Decapitator. Both have to do something with your head that you don't like. But it's really nice on your instruments. And I'm going to show you it over here. Going to remove it right now or bypass it. As you can hear, it also adds a little bit of character. You can use it on guitars, you can use it on vocals, you can use it on everything that you like to crush. But check it out. The link is in the description down below. This one is really funny because I already made a tutorial about sidechain compression and ducking. And this one is a free version of the Nicky Romero kickstart. It really sounds nice. Sometimes a little bit glitchy because I can hear it sometimes skips the way it has to duck. But okay, it's free, so we're not complaining. Let's move over to the next one. Over here, I have the Yuhei Tyrol number 6. It's really nice. Yuhei makes really good plugins. Diva, Zebra, and lots of other plugins. And this one is a free additional. I didn't research it yet why they made this version of the synthesizer, but it ends up in my house productions. And it's really great for bass or for extra layer on your synthesizers or make it even your lead sound. It's really great. Next one is Solonita. And this one is, yeah, sometimes for production in movies or in trailer productions, could might come in handy. I will show you the sound of it. Sounds pretty realistic, so we're going to move over to the next one. From the same company, we have Chamber Orchestra number 2, and it also sounds really realistic, this one. Okay, yeah, I didn't pitch it well because this section doesn't even exist. I have to move over to some of the notes. Really great to see this part, how I do that. Can even change the character, I thought, but for some certain sounds you can do that. Oh, this one is really high. Gonna lower down. So this was part 2 of the free VST guide. I hope you guys liked this video. Leave a comment below. Subscribe, hit the thumbs up and the notification bell. And I see you guys in the next video.